Hi there and welcome to this Kaleidoscribe tutorial. I'm Alice and by the end of this episode I want you to understand all the Spacefill basics you need in order to create your very own Spacefill artwork. Spacefill is a function that lets you fill objects with other objects whilst maintaining live functionality. In order, this tutorial will cover how to fill an object or path, resize all filling art, multiply filling art, vary size, vary rotation, and finally auto update artwork. Okay, so the important thing to know with Spacefill is in order to fill an object, we need three things. One or more container paths, i.e. any path, closed or not. In this case, the top section of my ice cream. Do note that if you're using multiple container paths, you'll need to make sure they are grouped together. Two, one or more objects to fill it with. Again, closed paths or not. These do need to be grouped as individual items, but don't need to be grouped as a whole. Also, make sure they're smaller than the container path in order for Kaleidoscribe to recognize they are fill objects. Three, the Spacefill panel, which is accessed by going to the window menu, scroll to Kaleidoscribe, then tick Spacefill panel. Use the selection tool to marquee and select the container and fill objects. Head over to the Spacefill panel, and if this is the first time you've used it, you'll see it will be set to default settings. All we need to do to activate it is press this make button at the top, and like magic, the sprinkles will fill the object. At this point, you'll see the options of release and expand replace the make button. Release allowing you to release the objects back to the original state, or expand to remove the live functionality, essentially locking in the shapes, turning them into everyday Illustrator objects. So you're probably thinking, what's so special about that then? Well, until I finalize the artwork by pressing expand, the artwork will stay live, meaning if I alter the container path, the fill art will always stay in it. I could change the size, move it, duplicate it, adjust the path. What's more, in this live state, we can use the panel options to adjust the fill. If I zoom in to focus on just the tick boxes on the lower half of the panel for now, the first being resize all filling art. If you tick this one and then enter a percentage value, it will change the fill objects accordingly. Let's skip these two for a bit and head straight to multiply filling art, where I can enter the number of duplicate copies I need. So if I enter a value of 4, it makes 4 copies of everything in my original selection. And if we go back to these two settings that I skipped, the second tick box is vary size. I'll just tick that and enter a value of 2, which will randomly multiply and divide the fill object by up to a factor of 2. Similarly, if I tick vary rotation, it will create a scattered effect. Okay, so we've covered 4 of the tick boxes. We just have this little one left at the bottom of the panel, which will be particularly useful if you're applying a very high number of copies to your fill, as it gives you the option of whether to auto-update the settings as you make them. What's important to bear in mind is that the plugin is making complex calculations in order to make the fill, so it may be best to turn off this option, which I'll cover next. So if I untick auto-update and make multiple changes, I can use the Apply Settings button to implement all those changes in one batch, saving precious time. So if I were to ask for 1,000 copies, it will do it, but it will take some time to implement, as we are asking a lot of Illustrator. During a heavy calculation, you'll get the spinning beach ball, followed by a progress bar with a stop button, which, if clicked a couple of times, will cancel the fill. Don't panic if Illustrator freezes temporarily, it's just working out the complex calculations that are needed to create the fill. And remember, it will still be infinitely quicker than placing the items yourself. So now you know how the Spaceful Basics work, I can show you how effective it was in creating my design. I've used a path to trace and section the outline of the ice cream, then coloured accordingly. To make the sprinkles, I've used Illustrator's rounded rectangle tool. I'm going to make my selection for the Spaceful and just keep applying and adjusting my settings until I'm happy. At which point I'll press expand to lock in the shapes. Great, I have a result I'm happy with. Which brings an end to this tutorial. We've covered all the basics of how to resize all filling art, vary size, vary rotation, multiply filling art, and finally auto update and apply settings. Watch the next episode to delve into even more advanced space fill settings. If you haven't actually bought Kaleidoscribe yet, download the free 14-day trial here and make sure you show us your finished artwork. You never know, you could become one of our featured artists. Thanks for watching.